So I'm a bit apprehensive because the SD card, I came back to the woods a few days ago, changed the SD card, and to my dismay, there was no footage at all recorded on that SD card, and even though it had been in the woods for a few days. So I changed cards. I got a feeling there's a problem with that SD card, so fingers crossed the new SD card has got some images on it. Yes, we have got some images, I'm glad to say. The camera's been triggered 86 times, so I won't know what I've got on there. I can't see very clearly on the little screen what I've got, but when we get home, we'll have a good look. Bought my old faithful again. I've really been enjoying this stove in the winter months. I don't think I'll use it so much now the weather's beginning to warm up, so this will probably be the last time I use it for a while. But it is, of course, the Optimus Svea 123R. That's my stove of choice today. I've got a nice little bit of grub to cook up on it. So I guess this is a shout out in a way to Harry. Harry, I've forgotten your channel name. So I'll put a link in the description box. If anyone who wants to go out and check out Harry's channel, because he done a little cookout recently. He went to his woods, nothing special, but I thought it was a good idea. The main ingredient was noodles, of course. That's what I've got here. But to these noodles he added chorizo sausage and sweet tomatoes, the cherry tomatoes, and cheese. And that's exactly what I got in there. So I'm going to add that to my pot of noodles, and that just reinforced the nutritional value, shall we say. So let's get the stove going. Yeah, I really do like my little Svea. Bit of old school. Nothing wrong with old school. Make sure the base is level. Best way to ignite the stove: trickle fuel down the burner rose. And then what happens? It goes down onto the reservoir. Well, there's a little depression where it gathers. That's it. we had a boil over. I had to get the pot off pretty quick. You have got a simmer ability with that little LeBurner, believe it or not. So anyway, let's add the extra ingredients. Half of it went on the woodland floor. I'm not too bothered. Let me tell you, when that little stove gets going, if you insulate the base, so well, it's warmer weather now, obviously, but in the winter, if you insulate the base, it builds the pressure up even more in the reservoir, and it really forces the fuel into the burner. And it's a powerful little stove, it really is. Ideal stove for cold conditions, but this is a beautiful day today. We're going in at spring. Signs of spring everywhere now. I was in the woods yesterday as well. I didn't film much, but I met up with my brother and also with a good friend of ours, Dino. He's a wood carver. He carves all the bowls and the spoons, and he's got, I think he calls himself Kestrel Craft. It's a retirement hobby for him, and he makes a little bit of money on the side. I think he's on Instagram. If anyone's interested in any of Dino's wares, bowls, cookses, spoons, etc., there'll be a link in the description box to Kestrel Craft. Go and check him out if you want.
Got loads of these. These two, actually came out one piece of wood like that, and it was split in there. I've got it on my Instagram, where I just put my axe in there, broke it open, and I mean, obviously I had to smooth them off. I always want to say call. That's cowl spoons. That shape.
Well, hold them still, so that will zoom in then.
Yeah, still wet as anything. Because that's the beauty, that's the trick, is to make sure that you keep them wet. But that's a sort of I guess you can make the cowl spoon to whatever you want it to be. But you can see the light through there. It's I don't know if that shows up. Does that show up there?
Probably if I was backlit, I'd see it. Yeah.
Other way around it wants to be.
Yeah.
But I've made three different sizes. So, and of course the big thing is that they've got to dry out. But just mugs and bowls.
So Dino, your website, it's called Kestrel Crafts.
Craft, with K's, both K's.
Okay.
Yeah.
The other thing, I was in the woods again. A few days prior, and out with Joe from Wessex Blazing Photography, and we took our cameras into the woods. I'd never seen so many elf cups. I just call them elf cups, but apparently they are scarlet elf cups because they're a very distinct red, and they're also inedible. Although I didn't take any to eat, but there was an abundance of them. And they're a fungi which is very prolific, apparently, from late winter into early spring. So basically from now until April, more or less, I think, you'll be able to find them. And then we Joe and I wandered through the woods looking for various compositions, and then Joe pointed out a nice one, so credit goes to Joe for this photograph. I took the photograph, but Joe sort of saw the potential before I did, and it was just basically two trees crossing, and it can make quite a nice photograph actually. Now, with this being filmed at the tail end of February almost, we're still under national lockdown. For anyone in the future watching this, this is late February 2021. I must admit, I am beginning to turn my mental cogitations towards touring on my motorcycle, going and seeing different places, making some sort of tentative plans as to what I'm going to do and where I'm going to go. I've got some outline plans to travel to Normandy on the Himalayan with some friends locally, and then I do feel a strong pull again to go up to Scotland, and I might even combine Ireland into that and the Isle of Skye. The Isle of Skye is quite accessible, so if I do part of the North Coast 500 like I did last year, anyone wanting to see that series, there's a link up here to the North Coast 500. Beautiful route, although going to the east side and down the east side wasn't so nice, so I'm probably going to do a slightly different route if I do go up to Scotland. I'm going to go right up along the west coast up to, and then along the north coast to a place called Hope, and then I'm bare right on a very rural road, and it takes you down through a place called Lockside, and then I forget the name of the little hamlet that it takes you through, but basically it takes you straight through the middle of the Highlands, and I think that's going to be a really magical route to go. So that's something I want to do. I'm not sure if I'm going to be doing that on the Himalayan or on the Suzuki V-Strom just yet. We'll see. There's pros and cons to both the bikes. The biggest con to the Himalayan is its lack of speed on the motorways, and the fact that it's got inner tube tyres, so if you get a puncture, you've got a lot more faff basically to get the puncture repaired. But with the V-Strom, if you get a puncture, it's tubeless, so you can get these easy kits, you know, and you can have yourself back on the road and rolling again in a few minutes. So I like the idea of that. But I also want to do a big tour on the Himalayan as well. We shall see. I'm not going to be going home hungry, that's for sure. Wash down with a nice cup of tea as well. Cheers. Anyway, if you've stuck with the video until this far, thanks very much. It is all now going to be about the footage that I've captured on my trail camera. There's always someone will ask, it doesn't matter what you say in your video, what information you give out, someone will always ask you. And the question that someone will always ask me whenever I do a trail cam is, what is the camera? And I always mention it, either in the description box or in the video. It is, it's called a 12MP, Power Extra 12MP. I don't think you can get it anymore. I believe I either purchased it from Amazon or eBay. If you can still get them, they're pretty sort of generic, and I would expect to pay somewhere in the order, I think I paid about £80 for this, but I think I'm seeing them online now for much cheaper than that, sort of £40, £45. And they're probably the same. they're not brilliant quality, but they give you an insight into the happenings of the woodland. And sometimes, you know, it's a bit like a spy, because the animals don't react to it. Foxes, I've noticed, do clock it. They'll look at it as they go past. It gives out an infrared, and it makes a little tiny clicking noise when it fires. And I think the foxes are tuned to that. The deer just totally ignore it, and all the other animals don't seem to be too bothered about it either. So yeah, I'm looking forward to seeing what images I've managed to capture on this. Let's hope it's something interesting. So that's me all done here now. I'm just going to pack up and get back off home. And the next thing you'll see is the edited images from the trail cam. I hope you enjoy them. So for now, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.